أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين صدق الله العظيم Surah Fatiha is the opening surah of the Holy Quran. That's why it is called Fatiha. Fataha means to open something. This surah is also given some other names in the Holy Quran. Like the Holy Quran itself says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ Indeed, we have given you the seven repeated verses and the Quran. Seven repeated verses, Sab'an min al-Mathani is also a name of the, given to Surah Al-Fatiha because there are seven verses in the surah and they are called repeated verses because we recite the surah in every rak'at of Salah. This surah is also known as Ummul Kitab, Mother of the Book, because all the major themes of the Holy Quran are discussed in this single surah. In the beginning of the surah, Allah talks about Tawheed. And then there is also the discussion about life after death in Malik Yawmiddin. There is also the rejection of Shirk, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in and so on. Almost all the major themes of the Holy Quran are discussed somehow in this single surah. And it is the first surah of the Holy Quran which was revealed on Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, as whole. Before this surah, all the revelations were the parts of some of the surahs, but the complete surah which was revealed on the Holy Prophet was Surah Al-Fatiha. This surah basically talks about Allah's relationship with humankind. And first of all, Allah says that Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, all praises be to Allah, the cherisher and sustainer of the world. The word Rabb is very important over here. The word Rabb tells us that Allah is the nurturer of the whole mankind. Allah is the one who provides all necessities of life to His creation. Rabb is one who nurtures, who converts a child into a strong man, who converts a plant into a strong tree. And whatever the creations need in their growth, Allah provides them all the things to them wherever they are. So this is the meaning of Rabb. And the word Al-Alameen means worlds. Over here it is used as plural because in this single world there are many worlds. There is a world of Jinnah, there is a world of angels, there is a world of humankind, and there is a world of birds and animals, there is a world inside waters. Allah alone is maintaining all these worlds. And it is also possible that there are worlds in the space because Earth, the planet of Earth, is a very small thing. In this vast space, it is possible that the life is present in other planets or in other parts of the space. The Holy Quran does not reject this idea. If there are worlds, Allah alone is maintaining them and controlling them. And why Allah is nurturing all the creations? Because Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, He is most gracious, the most merciful. Allah loves His creations even 70 times more than a mother loves her child. So it is His mercy that He cannot see His creation in difficulties. And being the creator and nurturer, He provides all the things they need for their survival. But at the same time, Allah reminds that there is a day when Allah is going to judge the people according to their deed. The surah says, Maliki Yawmiddin, Allah is the master of the judgment day. So it is another relationship of Allah with humankind that Allah is also their judge and Allah is also going to reward them and punish them according to their deeds on the judgment day. As we have already discussed it in Ayat al-Kursi where Allah said, مَنْ ذَلَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِي Who can intercede in His presence except by His will? So on the judgment day, Allah's decision will be final and His decisions will be based on justice and no one will be able to interrupt Him or challenge His decision. And then the surah also rejects shirk. Allah says, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ Only you we worship. It means that worshipping other beings is shirk. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ And only thy aid do we seek. It means that seeking support from other beings other than Allah is also shirk. The surah also teaches us a dua. The surah is telling us to say, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim, O Allah, show us the straight path. To give guidance to someone is also Allah's unique quality. and no one else has the authority to give guidance to someone. The Holy Quran says in Surah Al-Qasas, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Indeed, you cannot give guidance to those whom you love, but it is Allah who gives guidance. That's why we are taught in the surah to ask Allah for guidance, because if Allah will not decide for our guidance, even we ourselves cannot come on the right path. So Allah gives the guidance. And the Sirat al-Mustaqim straight way over here refers to the path and the guidance given in the Quran and Sunnah. Everything which is in the accordance of the Quran and Sunnah, that will be called the straight path. And everything which is contrary to the teachings of the Quran and Sunnah will be against the straight path, and all other paths will lead us towards Jahannam. And in the end of the surah, Allah also mentioned the good people and the bad people. It is also a way of the Quran that whenever Allah talks about the good people, Allah talks about the bad people as well. And whenever Allah talks about Jannah, Allah talks about Jahannam. So the same theme and the same style is there in Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah mentioned the good people first. Sirat al-Ladhina an'amta alayhim. Who Allah shows the path of those on whom you bestowed your mercy. And who were the people who got the in'am from Allah? They were the messengers of Allah, and they were the true followers of the messengers of Allah. They were the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, on whom Allah bestowed his mercy, and Allah gave them the reward. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. And O Allah, please do not make us follow the path of those who incurred your wrath and who went astray. According to majority of Mufassirin, the word المغضوب عليهم refers to the Jews, because they invited the ghadab of Allah, the wrath of Allah on them, because they made fun of Allah's commands, and because they killed the messengers of Allah, and they corrupted the word of Allah. And ad-dwalin, those who went astray, majority of the Mufassirin say it refers to Christians, because Allah sent Isa alayhi salam to them as a messenger of Allah, but they believed in him as the Son of God, and they innovated a new concept of Trinity, so they went astray. So we are asking over here in this surah that O Allah, make us follow the path of the messengers and his companions and the successful people, and do not make us follow the path who disobeyed your commands and who went astray and did not understand the religion. There are many things which Muslims can learn today from this surah, and they have to implement the teachings in their life today. First of all, we should praise Allah. The surah starts with the words Alhamdulillah, all praises be to Allah. It means that Allah has given us countless blessings. Each and every moment we are enjoying the blessings of Allah. So we should praise Him as well. We should thank Him as well. Though Allah does not need anything from mankind, He has everything. But if we will acknowledge Him, if we will praise Him, obviously it will make Allah happy. And this is the only thing we can do to make Him happy. And when Allah is Rabbul Alameen, so whenever we are in distress, we are in difficulty, so we should not look towards any other person. No one loves the creations more than Allah. No one has more powers than Allah. No one can solve our problems better than God. And no one can even understand our problems better than God. So that's why whenever we are in need, we should call our Rabb, we should call Allah for help. And the same thing is taught in the surah, Iyyaka Nasta'een, only Thy do we seek. It means that whenever we are in difficulty, we should not go to anyone else. Because if we will ask anyone else for the solution of our problems, that will be the insult of God. So that's why it is a part of shirk to seek support from other beings, because no one else can have more powers to solve your problems than Allah. And He is our creator, He is our maintainer, no one else. So whenever we need any kind of support, we should turn to God. This should be the relationship between mankind and Allah. And Maliki Yawmiddin reminds us that there is a day when we will be standing in front of Allah, and Allah will look into the deeds we have committed, we have done in our worldly life. So we should make sure that we are avoiding the sinful activities and we are doing maximum good deeds, so that on the judgment day we will not be feeling embarrassment in front of Allah. But by doing good deeds, we should try to achieve success on the judgment day. This is a reminder Maliki Yawmiddin is giving us constantly in all prayers. And then Ihdina Surat al-Mustaqim teaches us that we should constantly ask Allah for Hidayah. Because if Allah will not show the straight path, with our knowledge, we cannot find out the straight path. Allah's support and Allah's mercy and Allah's guidance is a must if we really want to achieve success and we really want to follow the straight path. Our knowledge and our intellect, our wisdom is nothing without Allah's support. So that's why we should ask Allah, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim, show us the straight path. And how can we follow the straight path? For this, first of all, we need to get the guidance from the Quran and Sunnah. It is obligatory on every Muslim to get at least the basic knowledge of the Quran and Sunnah, because without having the knowledge, how can we follow the guidance given in it? So first of all, we should strive to increase our knowledge and understanding towards the Quran. Only then we can be on the straight path. And the last part of the surah encourages us that we should make the prophets and his sahaba our role models. They should be our heroes and we should try to follow their lifestyle in our lives. Because when we know that they have achieved success and they are in Jannah, they have got higher strengths in Jannah, so it is very easy for us that if we will follow their footsteps in our life, we will also go to Jannah. That's why they are set as role models for us. And the Holy Quran also says, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. That Holy Quran says that if the believers will believe as the companions believed, if they will be like the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in their beliefs, in their actions, only then they can be successful in the next life. And we must avoid repeating the mistakes of the previous nations who incurred the wrath of Allah, and because of those mistakes Allah destroyed them and Allah gave them the torment. And we should not be like the Christians who misunderstood the beliefs about the messenger. About messengers, the beliefs are very sensitive. Believe in him too much, if he will raise his status more than the messenger is, that will become shirk, as the Christians did. They believed in him as the Son of God. And if we will not believe in the beliefs about the messengers in a correct way, that will be the insult somehow. So it is very important that we should understand the religious concepts correctly, sitting with the religious scholars and the true scholars of Islam. Otherwise, we can go astray. May Allah give us the guidance to follow the straight path, and may Allah give us the tawfiq to follow all the teachings of Surah Al-Fatiha. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.